everyone. I'm Niko, recent graduate of the SFCM TAC program. Show of hands, how many of you have heard of VR? Okay. How many of you have never tried VR? How many of you, okay, so one of you will get the opportunity to test this VR project out. This is something called Found. It was a tech demo that was created by a team of people at Make School in 2016. So who wants to try out Found? Who hasn't tried VR before? Why don't you? Yeah. Can we get? Do you have any motion sickness? No, okay. This is something that is actually a very important concern in virtual reality, because it can be very disorienting, especially for somebody who's never tried it before. And it's something that VR developers really have to take into account when designing systems for motion in 360 in VR. So luckily, this particular project called Found doesn't have very much physical motion, no flying around, nothing like that. So no, but that would be cool. I want to try that in VR. So let's test this to see if there's any audio. This is a risky proposition coming up here with all this technology. Now the computer is dead. Give me 1 second. So you, as the audience, are seeing now, what is your name? Athena. You are seeing what Athena is seeing through the goggles, okay? Athena, give me your right hand. There are two controls that matter here. Okay. One is the trigger, pull it up here, there you go. And one is the thumbstick, press it down towards the book, towards the goggles.
Where's the thumbstick?
Everyone, this is Found. Grab that slingshot with your left hand, or your right hand, doesn't matter. And you can grab the nut with your other hand. And if you successfully grab the ammo, you can pull it back. Break your way out of here. tech demo, demonstrating proficiency in Unity development and in applying different game mechanics. The team consisted of 6 people, all of which have gone on to successful careers in the video game industry. Everybody tries to get the dragon. Unfortunately, we didn't program it so that you can actually hit the dragon. if there was a next version of this, we would definitely make it so that you can nail the dragon. So this was created over 2 weeks. The composition process took about 2 weeks. The software that I used to create it is old now. I used samples from Mark of the Unicorn, which my teachers immediately told me, those are no good, use something more modern. And so I've taken all of their advice and have applied it towards the new compositions that I've been working on, including a VR cinematic called the Avaloki, which you can test out during intermission. This scene is the rain scene, so you can click on the triggers. Sometimes we had a couple of people actually sitting down on the ground to try to get at the level of the grass. There was another time that somebody like freaked out and fell down when the dragon flew at them. We've done this particular demo all over the place, from Upload VR to Samsung headquarters. This was an Oculus Launchpad project. So this has been all over the place. We've gotten something like 40,000 downloads. It's free. If you happen to have a VR headset, you can download it. No charge. And I guess I'll wait until this is over, but if you have any questions for me, I would be happy to answer them. Good question. This is something that comes up in video game composition all the time. Whether or not a piece of music is linear depends on the gameplay that it's attached to. This particular piece is more of a cinematic that's interactive than a kind of forking user-driven experience. So yes, this is, it's a linear composition. There are no loops, there are no layers. It just starts at the beginning, progresses through until the end.
So this will remain set up in an intermission if you want to forego a bathroom.